Yes, the fear of Allah is the most important force that directs our activities and all our characteristics with regard to having good morals. For instance, without the fear of Allah, a person may not feel the need to be patient or be able to endure hardship. He may not forgive. That is to say, he may not use his will in many instances. He may say, Allah will forgive me anyways. This rationale is also stated in the Quran, as you know. He may say, in any case, I will go to heaven. But with the fear of Allah, everything is brought under control. For example, he may not wake up for the morning prayers, or fast, or sacrifice himself for his loved ones. These are the foundations of zeal, love and passion. Without them, all of these concepts are demolished. That person becomes utterly empty. With the fear of Allah, a person develops wonderful details. That is to say, he gains traits like assiduity and honesty. With the fear of Allah, for instance, a person tells the truth. Without the fear of Allah, a person may easily tell lies for his own gain. That's what's going on today. Of course, the fear of Allah is at the root of honesty. A person tells the truth because he fears Allah. For instance, such person is a truthful witness. The fear of Allah prevents various dissension, fujur, unbounded wickedness and sinfulness, tumult and the anarchy in the individual soul. It allows us to make much more pleasure from heaven. Without it, a person is beset by a stiff dullness. All the beautiful aspects and details of the love for Allah come from fear of Allah. For example, patience comes from the fear of Allah and the roots of self-sacrifice, courage, compassion and all favorable attributes come from the fear of Allah. Also, fear of Allah is at the root of wisdom. That is to say, the minds of people are opened because of their fear of Allah. Otherwise, they remain closed and become atrophied. The fear of Allah opens the mind, ignites love for Allah and raises it to the heavens, inshallah. It opens the love of Allah toward eternity. It's a great blessing and creates a passionate love for heaven and for Allah. In other words, the more one fears Allah, the more intensively he loves Allah and the more of a spirit of a lover fills his soul. When one doesn't fear Allah, he loses his foresight, his perception, his benevolence, stability. All of his positive attributes begin to corrupt, or Allah forbid, they corrupt entirely. The whole matter is being in the party of Allah. Those siding with Allah are not defeated. They simply cannot be defeated. For this reason, if we love Allah wholeheartedly, if we genuinely side with Allah and fear Allah, and as long as we sincerely believe in Allah, we will never be defeated, in no way. As a miracle, Allah creates the entire universe in its boundless vastness and grandeur in our brains. He creates the love for Himself and fear of Himself also in our brains. A human being is a wonderful creation. As far as I recall, from a sacred hadith, Almighty Allah says, I do not fit into the heavens and the earth, but I fit within the heart of my faithful servant. This is an expression implying, I create everything within you. There exists a universe in the external world, but its real one is within you. But of course, this is for one who can think and understand deeply. For a person with a superficial outlook, for a man who eats meatballs and bread on the streets and wipes his mouth with the sleeve of his shirt, cannot grasp this. However, for someone thinking deeply, this is a subject that will give him a shiver. That is, someone who has a total grasp of this subject becomes unable to stand. He trembles with the fear of Allah and prostrates himself saying, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadan Rasulullah.
There is no God but Allah and Muhammad alayhi salam is his prophet. One recognizing this fact believes by 100%.
Yet there may be those kind of people who fail to grasp it and wander with open mouths. There may be those people unable to conceive this fact because of their ignorance. And there will be such people in all ages. Yet a time will come when Allah will manifest His attribute of Al-Hadi on all people and show these facts to people.